the next section of video, we'll focus on the first implement harness after the tractor cab. Starting at the front of the implement harness, we've got our two connections coming off of the tractor connections. You've got your high current power connection and your ISO plug connection. Those two connections come together in a Y where it becomes a single harness. That single harness will go across the unit. In this case, we've got it set up as a drill as the in-between harness. And the first thing we'll come to is we'll come to our ECU breakout, which will be somewhere in the middle of the drill. The ECU breakout will be identified when it tees off here. There'll be three small plugs at that break off as well. You're going to have what is labeled as a whisker switch, auxiliary power, and your safety loop. Safety loop is going to have a little loop cap on. It has to have that cap or the unit will not function. It'll also be identified at that T by this large ECU breakout harness. After the T, got it all coiled up there, but it'll continue on. And the next point of reference we're going to get to is the back of the implement harness, where you have, once again, your high current connection and your ISO connection. They split off at a Y right before the connection again, before they connect to the last implement harness. At our T in the harness, where we have the breakout wires and the ECU breakout, the function of these wires, your whisker switch here, can be tied in to run the lift lower. When lift lower is tied in, we also will have a power wire seen here getting power to power the whisker switch for the lift lower. And that power comes from the auxiliary power plug on that main trunk harness. If we follow that wire that's connected to those two connections, we'll go out here and it'll go up to the lift lower solenoid on the main block, which is going to tell, the monitor is going to tell whether it wants the oil to go one way or the other to control the lift and lower. We're going to have this plug here that is not used in lift lower scenario. There's a relay that is triggered by the whisker switch, and this is the connection going to the solenoid on the main block that's going to do the lift and lower. Also at this connection with our safety switch, that was the wire with the loop cap. That loop cap needs to be on that safety switch as it allows us to be able to remove this cap while working on the machine, which will allow us to safely work on the machine, leaving everything powered up and being able to test under load without actually being able to use any of the functions. At the ECU breakout is where the ECU breakout harness will be. If there is no ECUs for anything controlled on the drill, there will be a loop cap in place of this ECU breakout harness. If you have the ECUs, you can have ECUs for controlling Packmaster. You can have an ECU for controlling single run TopCon blockage. And you can have an ECU for doing sectional NH3 or liquid control. Now go through the connections at the ECUs on the first implement harness. I've removed all the corresponding harnesses except for the actual ECU connections. So in this scenario, we've got an EM24 doing blockage, an EM24 doing our liquid NH3 sectional, and we've got a CM40, which is going to do our Packmaster. So each ECU, as you can see, is going to be plugged into the comms here. And they're all going to have an ECU power, the 2-pin plug, and power, the 4-pin plug here. Doesn't matter whether it's a CM40 or an EM24, the power plugs both need to be used. The only difference is the comms plug on a CM40 is located in a different place. I've now removed all the other plugs other than the Packmaster from the CM40. So when I have the Packmaster installed, I'm going to want to be in channel 1. This will be CM40 number 3, and we're using channel 1 to control Packmaster. So if we follow this wire from channel 1, going all the way down, it's going to be on the drill. We can follow it all the way up to the front to the valve. Whether this is a high floater or standard valve, you're going to have your control plug that it's going to be plugged into. So your solenoid is going to look like this. It's got the hydraulic cartridge here, 2-pin plug, and you've got your pressure transducer here. And there will only be one of those as well, whether it's high flotation or standard. That's where the monitor gets the pressure from, so it knows what it needs to adjust this coil to. Where it gets its information from, we follow back, we come to this Y in the harness, and there will be a gray wire. That gray wire is going to go all the way to the back of the drill this time, to the packing load cell, which is located in one of the wheel hubs in the center of the mainframe. It uses a Turk connector here to control the Packmaster load cell through the harness. Packmaster works by getting information from the load cell spindle. It senses packing load when you get draft on the shank. More draft takes packing pressure away from the packing wheel, which then will tell it to increase the packing pressure through the solenoid. When it gets less draft, it's going to back it off to maintain that packing pressure. If you're running the Top Gun single run blockage, one of the EM24s on the drill will be used to control that. So if we get up to the ECU and we look down below, we've got one plug here and the inputs 1 through 14. That'll do 14 blockage sensors. So if you have a 6-manifold system dual chute, that'll give you enough for one on each tower. If you have an 8 or a 10, you're going to have one in inputs 15 through 28 to accommodate the extra sensors. All the leads are located right on that little sensor harness, and that's where the blockage sensors plug in. The ones right on that tower will not need extension harnesses, but if you need to go further out, extension harnesses are used to get the sensor away from this small harness. The second EM24 used for our liquid NH3 sectional will have a plug in relays 1. So we could control 2 products sectionally through this EM24. Need multiple drives coming off our main ECUs. So we've got one coming into the relays 1 plug, which is doing our section control. Also, at our ECU breakout on our main harness, we need to get power for this. So where the auxiliary power was that we were getting the power for the whisker switch, if you're using LiftMaster and liquid NH3, you have to put a T harness in like this. This T harness is 31-31-90, and that gives you the ability to split that power off. So you can see we get the power harness going out to our liquid NH3 sectional. So we follow those wires back. We come to another harness, this spider harness here, and we're going to have plugged into there the 2 harnesses coming both the sectional control and the power. The third harness being plugged into there is going to be coming from our main channel harnesses for our input drives for controlling rate, which is going to come off the ECUs on the tank, which we'll get